Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. We're just about to go explore that new town that I've just opened up access to after defeating that massive boss. But before that, I want to spend my souls because I'm really close to being able to afford a level up. So rather than risk losing my souls, I'm just going to pop a couple souls in my inventory and then actually level up. Let's go ahead and use all of them.
Welcome, speak. Very well, then take.
Yeah, I've got just enough. So, what do I want to spend it on? I'm gonna get more stamina.
Farewell, Ashen.
Also gonna go see if I can upgrade my Estic some more.
Tastes good. What?
See if I have enough pieces, even. No, I've only got one shard.
Pretty, be careful. I don't want to see my...
I can't do any of these other upgrades, can I? Also, how's my equipment doing? It's all fine. Infuse? I don't believe I have anything that I can actually infuse with. Nope. Nothing to reinforce. Nope. Okay.
Pretty, be careful.
Let's go explore. Oh, one more thing. I don't want to forget about the key that I can get here. Because I remember I can buy a key from you. Yes, the tower key. Key to the dilapidated tower behind the shrine. 20,000.
Ashen one.
I think I'll wait a bit to get that. Because right now, honestly, there's just no realistic way I can actually save up enough souls to get that right now. I'm gonna have to wait till I'm later in the game and get more souls at a time. I don't think you're meant to get it this early. Undead settlement at the foot of the high wall. Summon sign. That's to summon somebody to my aid, right? I think it is. Yeah, I don't need help. So it's fine. Gonna need some way to get inside of the gate. Looks like there's a lever down there. Little area off to the left side. Okay, seems simple so far. No, don't summon. Meant to read the note. Visions of Sniper. Oh my god, look at that down there. Another dragon corpse. Also, something's on fire down there. Oh, there's another fire. Guess they're like watchtowers or something. Or sentry points? I don't know what you call those things. Signal towers? Signal tower makes more sense, more than a watchtower. Oh. Whoa. I feel bad for the undeads. They're always just getting mauled and killed. Whether it's Cthulhu monsters or dogs. I've got a bad feeling about going this way. Oh, hey. Okay. Well, they didn't see me anyway. Alluring skull. Right, that attracts certain types of enemies, right? That's one of those items that I think I literally, like, never used in the entirety of Dark Souls 2. A skull resplendent in the scent of souls, prepared by the evangelists of the Cathedral of the Deep. Throw to shatter, spreading souls which attract enemies. Not effective for all foes. Ally ahead. Sure. I'm just gonna preemptively drink.
Please, grant me death. Undo my shackles.
One of them's alive. I thought I saw one moving from up there, but I thought it was just the wind. Like blowing the fabric, but no. The others don't move at all.
Oh. Oh, then it's true. A champion of Ash, as I live and breathe. To be in your presence is a great honor. I am Njol of Londor, a pilgrim, as you can see, only somehow I failed to die as was ordained. Well, perhaps my calling lies elsewhere. Say, champion of Ash, how does the idea of taking me into your service strike you? I was once a sorcerer. Surely I can be of use.
Sure? Can you define exactly what being in my service entails? Sure.
Oh, I am honored, truly. I should be dead, yet you have granted me purpose anew. I, Njol of Londor, do solemnly swear myself to you.
I guess he'll appear later to help me at some point. Wait a minute. There's some way to get over there. Because I see items to pick up. Look at that. How do you get over there? It's not something I can drop down onto, is there? No. Wonder if at some point I can get a lift from those creepy bird creatures? Oh, hey. This is so, I don't know, I really like the aesthetic of this place. Like the crows and the sort of like scarecrow undead monsters almost. Did I kind of stun them just by rolling into them? I didn't know that was a thing. It just, the aesthetic of this place reminds me of like a, almost like a campy horror movie, you know? I mean, look, there's like a body hanging from a rope there. There's like scarecrow zombies, zombie dogs, ravens flying away ominously. I like it. Oh, right, the dogs are back. Maybe I'll just close this. Visions of Sniper. Whoa. Purple. Why are these purple? This is a mad phantom. Will you summon it? No? That doesn't sound good. What will happen if I summon a mad phantom? And what was that noise? The sound of a new summoning sign appearing, perhaps? Thanks for the rubbish. What can I do with the rubbish? Rubbish of no value and certainly no avail. Who in their right mind would bother carrying this around? Perhaps you need help. We'll see about that game. I'm gonna carry every single one around with me for the entire game, and at the end, oh man, it's gonna pay off. It's gonna pay dividends. Ugh. Oh, don't tell me I have to cut the body down. Ugh. God, this is gross. Ew. I'm gonna roll less around bodies. I don't like it when they flop to the ground. Let's take a look at the small leather shield. It features a large central protrusion designed for parrying attacks. Yes, that's a small shield. So it's a parry shield. Is there some way to jump to the other side? Doesn't seem like it. Pretty sure I would just fall. Oh, hey. Oh god, what is that thing? Creepy little gremlin monster. Is that what I came over here for? A gremlin monster? Ugh. There's gotta be something up here, right? A hint? A clue? Something out the windows? It's so, like, secretly guarded. Hmm. I don't know if I want to be here. Oh my god. This game is so damn creepy. There's a big one next to the tree. You know what this reminds me of, actually? I just realized what this seriously reminds me of. This reminds me of Resident Evil 4. Like the, when you first get to the village. A large group of essentially like axe-wielding zombies. And there's one big dude. I don't think they have a chainsaw, but this really reminds me of Resident Evil 4. Oh, don't fall. Worker hat. Maybe I can blend in with the people. It is terrible. Official attire for the dissection and burial of undead. Naturally, the ceremonial significance of such work is long forgotten. Indeed, no one could continue to entertain such horrors. I look so beautiful. Charcoal pine bundle. That's gotta be a temporary damage upgrade, probably giving fire. Yep, fire to right-hand weapon. Just like the gold pine resin. Could use that fighting the frost monster. What are these bundles? This human-shaped bundle seems awfully small, does it not? I would say it's a child, but it seems too long and thin to even be that. Okay, I think I'm about to fight like 10 enemies at the same time, so I'm gonna switch out to my serious armor. See if I can avoid attracting their attention for as long as possible. Just let me grab this, Loretta. Loretta. I'm supposed to give the ring to Loretta. The person from the jail cell. I found her bone? Old human bone with several holes bored into it. A woman's corpse in the undead settlement was found clutching this bone. Her name was Loretta. Well, this is her corpse. I was supposed to give her the ring. How do I give her the ring? She's dead. What do I do with the bone? Let me try taking the ring off, see if that does anything. Like, maybe you can only give it or use the bone if you don't have the ring equipped. No, I can't use it. Huh. It says consumable. Weirdly enough. Perhaps I used the bone inside of the jail cell? But, I mean, the guy isn't there anymore, though. I don't get it. Do I need to find all of Loretta's bones and reconstruct her body? Are her bones strewn throughout the Seven Kingdoms? Good thing they're deaf. Yeah, should I just start hacking at them? Maybe they won't even attack me. There's an explosive barrel right there. Let's get this party started! Oh, no one cares. I didn't mean to do that. Okay, party started.
Poor child, come to me.
I do not want your fiery embrace. Okay. Got some serious ads to take care of. It's really weak. It's incredibly easy to avoid. Let's get the ads. Oh, what is that thing? What the fuck is that thing? I don't know what those are, but I'm guessing if they hit me, I'm gonna be having a bad time. Run, run, run. Okay. Where'd you come from? Oh, I didn't think that'd reach. No, not that again! Okay, we're good. Battlefield is clear, come on. Do your fiery hug. Yes, yes, fiery hug. No, that's not the fiery hug. That's the fiery hug. Oh, come on. I just need one hit point of damage. Okay.
Come to me.
Didn't even drop anything. I feel like I just fought a mini boss, but if it didn't even drop anything, then I guess it wasn't. Estus Shard, yes! Ooh. I'm gonna need to use a bow to shoot that down. Okay, I've never used a bow before, but I'm sure I can make this work. There's a way to manually aim. I've loaded it. That's not how you manually aim. Maybe I need to two-hand it? No. There we go. Okay, yeah, so it looks like you need to equip it, you need to two-hand it, and then press the left button. That feels really gross. Gonna unequip the weapon though, because it's gonna add to my weight. Kukri. 9 of them. Oh, I guess they're like throwing knives. Let's take a look at them real quick. Throwing knife causes bleed damage, throat foes to inflict damage. Doesn't say how much damage either of them do, but they look bigger, so I'm assuming they do more. Anything down the well? Creepy noises emanating forth? Nope. I feel like I should go back to the bonfire, because I'm out of Estus. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to go back to the bonfire. Refill my Estus and also upgrade my Estus, since I have an Estus shard. Oh, closing the gate. The dogs are still on this side. maybe they just won't hear me, right? Yeah, I'm fine. Can I do anything with Loretta now that I know this is Loretta? I guess not. Should I use more bombs? I hear that person padding around up there. They're not gonna jump down, are they? I think I'm good. Oh, come on. You can throw better than that. Oh man, if you're just more aggressive, those are they're actually really easy. Backstab, backstab, backstab! Almost got the full worker attire. Thank you. Yes, got one. I'm so satisfied that I got a plunging attack there. It looked like I missed. In fact, I think I kind of did, but somehow it hit anyway. So, do I go that way, or do I go across this bridge? I don't know. Let's go this way first. Jesus. It's funny how the mood and tone of a game makes such a difference. Because there's so many bodies. There's so many bodies, and I'm just thinking back to Outlast. When I played Outlast, Outlast had way too much. It went over the top with its violence, with its blood, with its gore. There were just bodies and blood strewn everywhere. To the point where it was just kind of... I was just desensitized to it and it was comical. But here, for some reason, it's actually effective. I mean, if this is all I saw everywhere, I guess it wouldn't be, but... I guess because the game is so much more careful with its tone, this is actually creepy to me. Whereas in Outlast, it wasn't. I don't know, just interesting little thing to note. In a different context, doing a similar thing can actually work. As long as they don't keep doing this, though. If every single room is filled with a million bodies, then yeah, I'm gonna get desensitized to it. Soup ahead. What? I don't think I want to fall down there. Oh, fuck! The fuck?! Jesus Christ, okay! This game is way too damn creepy. So any one of these things could be a fucking enemy! Oh my god! That makes me so uncomfortable! This fucking game... It's so good! It's so good! At being unnerving. Now I'm just gonna look at every single one with fear. Oh hey, there is soup down there. When they said soup ahead, they literally meant it. I love soup. And good, the cook isn't here. Drink Estus soup. Estus soup? Okay. Oh, heals you. Delicious. Warrior of Sunlight. Is that a covenant? It is. The Warrior of Sunlight Covenant. Is that the Sun Bros? Praise the Sun. An ancient talisman depicting a holy symbol bestowed upon the Warriors of Sunlight. Equipped to pledge oneself to the Warrior of Sunlight Covenant. They're brilliantly beaming cooperators who place their golden signatures to help those in need, for it is their duty to deliver a great conquest to their summoner. Way of Blue, or the Way of the Yellow? Ah, I can't pass them up, can I? But I still can't praise the sun, can I? No. Oh, You can spot which ones are creatures. You can see they move slightly. Well, not to mention you can target it. But yes, it moves slightly. Hi. This one's also alive. Secret? I love finding secrets in Dark Souls, it's so fun. Unfortunately, often your reward is just some souls, which is not the most special thing to find. But it's still satisfying nonetheless. I gotta remember to look up too, in case there's a body I can shoot with an arrow. Oh. They see me. Try to stay calm. Okay. Why? Is there something in here? It's so easy to make them stumble. I think you just gotta run for it. Oh, hey. I see what they mean about staying calm. Gotta like run, take cover, run, take cover. Oh, and I got a whip. Another whip that was never intended for use in combat. Of little use against armor and tough scales, but quite formidable against enemies with exposed skin. Strike from the left to evade shields and deal a stinging blow that temporarily slows stamina recovery. The shackles of bondage lie deep in the hearts of all humankind. What's the special attack on the whip? Whoa! Fancy. Oh, hey! Spiked mace, yet another weapon. So many weapons. Requires a lot of strength, 21. And the base damage is super high, about 150 instead of 100. Not gonna be making use of that thing. Treasure ahead. Huh. Titanite shard. Awesome. Oh, and there's a bonfire over there. Lizard ahead, therefore left. Gotcha. Aha, I see you. I think I could do a plunging attack on it, probably. Or not. No! Come back here! Come back! No, come on! What? Oh, now I'm being invaded by a holy mad spirit. Okay. That's so lame. My character wouldn't aim down. I quite clearly had the chance to hit it, but they just would not aim down. Okay, so I think I'm being invaded by a player, right? Yep, probably. Where are you? Let's get up to full health. Where's this mad spirit? Oh, there they are. Hi! Are they human? Is a mad spirit human? Okay! Don't know if they're actually human. What? Oh, fuck me! Oh, I'm not gonna let you do a plunging attack, come on. I don't know if that's human. What is that? I don't know what that thing is. Can I lock this? Light this bonfire? Oh, cool. Please come down here. If I go around, I'm gonna attract an enemy. Come on. Ah, fine. Come on! Come around! You are not gonna be attacked by the enemy. I will be. You come around. My attack was fancy, but it didn't work. I don't know what that thing is. It's just like a distraction, I think.
Oh man, what? How did that attack miss? Are you serious? I don't know how that missed. And I still don't know if that was a human. I really don't. I feel like it wasn't. I feel like a human would have emoted or something. Oh. Well, anyway, at least I got my souls back. Alright, let's go level up and then call it a day, I think. Made some really good progress.
Welcome home, I should speak very well then.
I think I can afford, yeah, just one level up. I'm not sure whether to go for dexterity or strength. I think I want to go for one of those. Because I've been spending a bit on endurance, vigor, and vitality, and not much on strength or dexterity. I think I'm going to put another point into strength. Yeah, let's do that. Because I kind of want to work up to the point where I can use the halberd. I don't know, like, I want to go back to Helby. Good old Helby from Dark Souls 2, but I really like the S-Stock. So how much I want to keep putting points towards strength to get up to it, I don't know. I don't need that much more strength, though. I only need 16 strength to be able to use it effectively. So it's really not that many more points. Yeah, I'll keep working up to it. Alright, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm going to go back to the dilapidated bridge.